Good to see you, Ken.
Hey, what's going on?
Oh,
Mike?
Not
what's
much.
Going on?
Yeah, had a good time at the barbecue
yeah,
the other day.
Yeah, man, that was good. That was good.
Yeah.
Sticky fingers.
Yeah, I do have to admit, though, I get a little uncomfortable when you guys, like, start all the praying stuff, you know? That's just not where I'm at now.
And, well, I mean, why does that make you uncomfortable? I mean, it's kind of who we are. We're,
well, I mean, I don't know. I've gotten more to a point where I'm questioning things from a more scientific point of view, and I just don't believe, you know, all the stuff that, you know, our parents taught us just because they believed it, you know.
Well, I mean, I believe in science too. I mean, but, you know, what makes you, what specifically are you questioning? I mean, you know, it's...
Well, I mean, with all the evil in the world and all the bad things that happen, I think if there's really a loving God, why would he let those things happen? And there's been times when I've prayed and I didn't get an answer, so I thought if he loved me so much, you know, he would answer the question or answer my prayer, you know.
I hear what you're saying, but, you know, a lot of things that happen to us, buddy, you know, is some of it's going to be, you know, we make choices. And then when we make a decision, sometimes it's going to have a good result, sometimes it's going to be bad, and sometimes things are just going to happen to us. So the question is how we're going to respond to it. It doesn't mean that God doesn't love us. I mean, that there's no God. I mean, even as a Catholic, I'd say, you know, Jesus, who was God, died on a cross for all of us, and he suffered. And if he was willing to suffer, why should I think any less of myself, you know?
Well, I don't know. I wonder if, you know, if even some of that stuff is even true, you know? I mean, they say, you know, just because it was written in the Bible, I mean, that was 2,000 years ago, and it's probably been retranslated a bunch of times. I mean, who knows, you know, who put their own take on there, you know?
Well, all I can tell you is, like, if you take the time to look at some of that stuff, you'll see that faith has been handed on, you know, faithfully. The resources are out there, and we don't want to come to any rash judgments. But I can tell you this, buddy. You know, all I can say is that going to church, my faith in God, it's changed my life. I can see his fingerprints all over my life. He's made me a better person. He's made me a better father and a husband. And while those things may not be tangible, it's very real to me. It's changed my life. It's changed everything. Have you heard about the miracle of the Eucharist?
No.
Well, there was this priest back in the 8th century. He was questioning his belief in God and whether, you know, at Mass we believe that the bread and wine are transformed into the body, blood, you know, soul and divinity of Jesus, that it's the bread is no longer bread, the wine is no longer wine. It is Jesus' presence there with us, and we receive him. And the priest was questioning, and he was saying Mass. And when he said the words of consecration, it started to bleed. It started to bleed, and they preserved all that. And it's still over in the church in Italy. It's heart tissue.
Hmm.
And and they got little fragments of the blood that are still there. It's still preserved after all this time. It hasn't turned to dust.
And this is something I can, like, read about and there's find the historical evidence.
Dude, I got
for?
The website. They've had scientists look at it. They can't explain it.
I'd be interested in reading about that, finding out more about that.
But my point is, man, is that even though there's all those things you can look at, you have to look into your own heart. You know, if there's a void in your life, if something bothers you, there's something missing, okay? And it's God. He loves you so much. And all I ask is that next time when you have some silence, that you just take the time, you know, when you're by yourself, to just think about some of this stuff and, you know, just have an open heart and an open mind.
Well, I mean, I guess there is kind of a emptiness in certain areas of my life that I don't really know how to label it, you know, what it is. But I guess it's a little hard to make yourself vulnerable, you know, to something you can't see.
Maybe when we prayed at the picnic last week, the reason it made you feel uncomfortable is because you haven't really finished dealing with this kind of stuff yet.
Yeah, maybe you're right.
You can spend some time with it.
Well, I'd like it if maybe we could get together some more and have some more conversations like this.
I wonder if we have some more barbecue.
Yeah, there you go.
That was a good time. Hey, you know what? Thank you for trusting me enough that you, you know, brought this up. I mean, that means a lot that you're, I mean, this is very personal. So the fact that you're bringing this up to me means a lot. So you're a good friend. We know it's all good.
Thanks, man. You are too.
Cool.